Dear learners, I am Dr. Shrihari Hasabnis. Today we will discuss about abiotic disorders in a pomegranate crop. In addition to biotic causes, the pomegranate crop also suffers from few abiotic reasons. Biotic and abiotic. Biotic means wherein biological entities are involved to lead to abnormalities. And in some disorders, these biological entities are not involved, those are called as abiotic causes. What are those abiotic disorders in pomegranate? First and most important is fruit cracking. Fruit cracking is a serious problem in pomegranate. This disorder can be observed at any stage of the fruit development. It means right from the fruit is of arecanut size till its full growth, means till its harvest, we can observe cracking disorder. The malady is thought to be due to boron deficiency in young fruits, while in mature fruits or in developed fruits, it is caused due to variation in a soil moisture content as well as atmospheric humidity. At the time of fruit ripening, if the soil becomes too dry, means deplete in soil moisture, and then immediately irrigated heavily, or naturally if it is unexpected rains occurring, we observe cracking in a fruits. The cracking is correlated with rind thickness, means rind thickness of the fruit. Some of the pomegranate cultivars like Gulesha, Bedana, Khog and Jallor seedless are comparatively tolerant to fruit cracking. Now, how to manage this fruit cracking? Yes, it is possible to take some preventive measures well in advance, and then we can avoid cracking of the fruits. First thing is regular irrigation to maintain proper soil moisture level at a desired status. Another thing is planting of windbreaks. Where we have to plant? We have to plant windbreaks around the pomegranate orchard. Some spraying also helps in reducing the cracking or avoiding cracking of the fruits. Those are spraying of calcium nitrate at the rate of 5 gram per liter of water. If this is followed by spraying of borax at the rate of 2 gram per liter on young fruits, reported to be minimizing the fruit cracking. Remember well, these two, calcium nitrate and borax, are not to be mixed together. Those are to be separately sprayed at their respective concentrations. Another approach is mulching. Two types of mulch we can use. One is organic, means sawdust, paddy husk can be used as a mulch. Another is black polythene sheets are also found useful as a mulch to reduce the cracking problems. Spraying of antitranspirants like kaolin at the rate of 10 gram per liter, or power oil at the rate of 1.5 ml per liter, and liquid paraffin at the rate of 1 ml per liter are found very much beneficial over the cracking problem. This is about cracking of the fruits. Another second most important disorder is blackening of aerials. The fruit which is apparently matured looks like very good, very intact from externally. But when we'll open it, we'll find some of the fruit aerials in a particular segment of the fruit. On severe cases, in a complete fruit are found brown or black discolored. In advanced stage of this discoloration of the aerial, fruits produce foul smell. Initially, there is a loss of pigment from aerial. Aerial becomes abnormally soft, shriveled, and turn brown, and finally they turn to black in color. It is a complex, means discoloration of the aerial is a complex, resulted because of different genotypes of the pomegranate, season of the fruiting means which bahar we have taken, fertility, condition of the soil, imbalance supply of the nutrients, and stage of the maturity of the fruit. This have impact on aerial discoloration. The incidence is more in Ambia bahar. Incidence occurs 90 days after anthesis and harvesting between 180 to 200 days after the fruit set is recommended to reduce this problem. The exact cause of this malady is unknown even now. This is about the aerial discoloration deformity. Next deformity is sun scald. Sun scald is a major disorder of a pomegranate. We observe in nature, especially during the hot days. When fruits are growing on a plant, we observe the fruits in two situations. One situation, those are hidden in the canopy, inside the canopy. Of them, the scald is not a problem. Whereas, in other situation, the fruits which are directly facing to bright sunlight, these show the sun scald symptoms. In sun scald abnormality, the rind color turns into brownish. Not only color turns brownish, surface also becomes rough. This abnormal fruit color will not fetch good price in the market, even though inside aerials are of good quality. Easy to manage this sun scald abnormality. Here, one has to begin this management thinking in a fruit development stage. In our area, we can find there are two ions of the Surya, means sun. From 14th of January to 21st of June, that is Uttarayan, and from 16th of July to 22nd of December, that is a Dakshinayan. We can retain maximum fruit exposed to the sunlight opposite to the respective ayana. This way, we can minimize or lower the sun scald problem with simple management theory of retaining fruits or removing the fruits. Another management practice is covering the fruits with inverted paper discs. Very simple way. Simply staple these paper discs just above the fruit. Some of the growers, they are using special type of white cloth to cover top of tree canopy. Also, application of potassium nutrient like 0050 at the rate of 5 to 7 gram per liter through foliar application at late stages help in better pigmentation and expected shiny color to rind of fruit. Last one deformity in a pomegranate is unusual flower drop. Every pomegranate grower commonly worry about the fruit set. He complained about this flower drop abnormality because for a good harvest of the fruit from orchard, fruit setting should be well, means fruit setting as well as emergence of flowers is a prime important. In many cases, we can find good flowering with good ratio of hermaphrodite flowers, but final resulting poor fruit set is abnormality here. It has many reasons. However, with good and healthy management of the orchard, if we experience this abnormality, then reason may be of poor pollination. In nature, honeybees are the good pollinating agents in many crops. How the pomegranate will be an exception for this? So, honeybees play important role in a pollination. So, it is advisable that in orchard, there should be easy and plenty access to bees. For this, rear bees with boxes in our orchard. Another, bees are attracted towards yellow flowers that we are knowing. So, what can we do for grow few yellow flowering plants? Classic example grow Niger-like crop nearby. It will flower with plenty of yellow colors and the bees will be attracted to it. Another care we should take, avoid use of strong insecticide. Example, thymethoxam, imidacloprid, etc. These chemical insecticides harm bee movement in the orchard. Growers also can invite bees in our orchard simply by hanging jaggery soaked gunny bags hanged here and there in our orchard. So those sweet jaggery soaked gunny bags will invite many more honeybees in our orchard, will facilitate the pollination. So herewith I would like to conclude our this topic, balanced nutrition, clean cultivation, minimum use of highly toxic chemicals, eco-friendly approaches can produce quality fruits in our orchards. Thank you very much.